Welcome to the lesson on nets for cubes. In this lesson, we will take a look at what qualifies a net to be a cube, and how we can quickly distinguish the nets that do from the nets that don't, along with some exercises for those nets. Now, ominoes can be folded three-dimensionally and made into cubes. Recall that a cube is a prism that's equal on all edges and faces. As shown here, a cube has six faces, its edges, and can be made from ominoes. Now, if we take a look at these pentominoes, we looked at with those five faces, no matter any way that you might fold those faces, you're going to be left with an open side. A cube has six faces. So in order for us to make a cube from this omino, we're going to need more than five squares. We're going to precisely need six squares. But the way that we arranged those six squares must be very important. Closing a cube. To close a net for a cube, all six squares in your omino must represent a unique face of the cube. No square should overlap, and no sides should remain open. Now let's think about how I can turn this hexomino into a cube. Let's signify this side as the bottom. While I could turn any side in theory into the bottom, we'll just say it's this side for now. These two sides will fold up to the bottom, along with these two sides, signifying that all four of them together would be sides of our cube. And as the side on the right folds, this one gets folded twice and ends up right above the bottom with, of course, a space in between, so it becomes our top. Those six faces, when folded correctly, made a cube. Now, there are many ways we can arrange the hexomonos to appropriately make a net for a cube, and, of course, there's a lot of non-nets. But take a look at some examples of a non-net. This one, no matter how many times I fold it, would ultimately get some of the sides overlapping and have two openings. This one, while we could specifically have a front, would leave an opening on one side. Looking at them overall, the orange ones could be folded and manipulated to make into a perfect cube with no gaps, and the white ones either have not enough faces, like those with five, or would leave gaps because there would be overlaps. At the end of the day, we can look at these examples and know that we can carefully evaluate them and fold them in a variety of ways to see if they actually work. Now, when thinking about cubes, much like when we think about dice, how can we identify what the opposite faces are? How can we manipulate these ideas in our mind visually to address what some of these problems are? So if I'm looking at this cube and I think, well, what is on the other side of the D? Well, because the D and the E are next to each other, and the C would be on the other side, the B would be on the exact opposite side of the D. Now to think, what would go on the top? What goes on the missing blank? Well, imagine the B will fold over, bringing the A to fold over on top, and be oriented as such, facing towards the top side of the D. Now, if I take a look at the bottom cube, I have symbols. I have the little hashtag symbol on one side, and the upside down exclamation point. And that signifies to me that not only have I made this cube, but that I flipped it upside down. But looking at the same pattern, I would see that the at symbol would be on the opposite side of the hashtag. Now, how do I fill in that blank side? Well, looking at that question mark and seeing how it would be folded next to the exclamation point, I would see where the dot would be and how it would be oriented. Continue to practice these, and don't be afraid to make your own models.